Hello and welcome to Battlefield 4 News, episode 45, and this episode's all about the latest patch. So this is the patch that's hit on the 25th and the 27th for consoles, but hasn't yet hit the PC because of technical difficulties. So I'm covering this now because all the patch details for the various consoles are the same. So I'm going to be using the PS4 console patch notes as my reference point, but all the other consoles have the same notes. So the Xbox One, which was released on the 27th, PS3, which is on the 25th, and the Xbox 360, which was also on the 25th. So let's get started. And first we're into the fixes. So there's the general stability improvements, a fix for a crash that could occur when a player were customizing vehicles, a fix for an issue in the rush game mode where the end of round screen would always indicate there were 60 minutes left of the game, a fix for an issue where the splash damage of infantry fighting vehicle shells, helicopter rockets and mortar rounds were unable to destroy deployed equipment. That's a problem that's been around for a while. Fix an issue that would cause the quad bike to explode when it hit indestructible objects. Fix for an issue that would cause sniper rifles to display too much bloom aiming in snowy conditions, especially outside areas of Operation Locker. So in Operation Locker, sniper rifles on the outer lanes were pretty much useless if you kept them zoomed in for more than a couple of seconds. They fixed the issue where the ECM would sometimes fail to jam incoming missiles. They've shortened the takeoff distances for jets so they can actually leave the runways in second assault maps. They fixed the ceiling exploit in Operation Metro, only 3 years after Operation Metro first came out. They fixed another MAV riding exploit. They fixed the kill camera jittering strobing sometimes if colliding with other objects or terrain. And they fixed soldiers getting catapulted when walking up steep surfaces. So no more flying into the distance. Now we get onto some issues that have been labelled netcode. They fixed the kill camera so it will actually show who killed you rather than somebody who just damaged you or one of your own teammates. They fixed an issue where the kill card won't show up when playing on servers that have the kill camera turned off. So that means you'll still get the kill details but you won't get the video of the person that killed you. Fixed an issue where soldiers would appear to fire in the wrong direction when turning quickly, and they fixed weapons firing twice or not at all in some instances. The firing twice I've had a few times and it's most noticeable with rocket launchers. So you would fire off a SRAW and then the animation for the SRAW firing again would go off, but you'd only have one missile in the air. They fixed the issue where explosions didn't do any damage to infantry and vehicles that were outside the combat area. The typical example of this was the AA or the rocket artillery hiding in their own spawn. So for you, they were out of bounds and it didn't matter what you did, you couldn't actually damage them in there. They fixed the levolution on Parasol Storm and Flood Zone. Because those events took a long time to complete, if you joined halfway through, you could sometimes see the destroyer beached where everybody else was still seeing it heading towards the shore. And they fixed an issue that could cause packet loss. They're adding gold battle packs as a reward for a class service star. So this is because if you reach max rank, you stopped earning battle packs, and therefore you could get to max rank and not have unlocked all the attachments for weapons that you get within the battle packs. And it also means that players leveling up will get more battle packs in general. So now we get onto the interesting stuff, which are the tweaks. They've increased the damage that Buckshot will do against targets in body armour. And they've reduced the vertical recoil of the M4 and the M16A4. So this is going to make them more like they were in Battlefield 3. So these are going to be tight burst guns at medium to long range. At the moment they've been a bit weak because they're burst fire, which means they're tricky to get a consistent rate of fire out of, and they haven't had the accuracy bonus that they should get. They've reduced the side-to-side recoil and first-shot recoil on the G36C. Now, the G36C is acknowledged to be the worst gun in the game. Now, is reducing its recoil going to give it enough bonuses against the AK-5C? I don't think so. They've reduced the detonation time of the 40mm LVG, so that means you're not going to be able to bounce it off two or three walls anymore, and they've also reduced its damage down to 80. So this thing isn't going to be as lethal as it has been in Lockers and Metro. They're also reducing the number of 40mm grenades you can carry for the HE and the LVG to 3. And it's taking longer for those grenades to reload from an ammo box. But it's now going to be slightly quicker to reload the smoke and the flash grenades. So this is the first of the steps they're introducing to try and reduce grenade spam, by making you carry less of the 40mm grenades and making them reload slower. They're also increasing the reload time of the RGO Impact, the V40 Mini, the M48 Flashbang and the M18 Smoke Grenade. So standing on an ammo box means that these will reload slower. This is going to help with grenade spam, but it's not going to stop it. The easiest way to reduce grenade spam is have it so you get one RGO or two V40 Minis. That would reduce grenade spam and actually put some skill back into using grenades. They're increasing the suppression effect of mounted vehicle weapons, so that's the minigun, the heavy machine guns, the light machine guns, and tank and infantry fighting vehicle shells. Do we really need that? Probably not, but it brings it in line with the other guns. And we have yet more aircraft tweaks, except this time we have some good ones. They further reduce the rate of repair for scout helicopters and transport helicopters, so they're taking into account that you can have two repairers sitting in the back of each. And they're significantly increasing the damage of transport helicopter miniguns, which they've needed since the game launched. They're really pathetic at taking out infantry. They're increasing the flight ceilings on Gulf of Oman, Caspian Border and Operation Firestorm, and that's because they've all got really tall buildings and towers in them. Lastly, we have a decision that confuses me slightly. They've adjusted the damage of the 25mm and 30mm cannons on stealth jets and mobile AA to do equal damage per second to the 20mm cannon. Now, I can understand this for jets because the cannons roughly do the same job. It's just, do you pick something that's hitting hard for every single shot, or something that's firing more shots? But for the mobile AA, this is more difficult to justify. It says that these weapons were clearly poorer choices in all circumstances, but for the mobile AA, that simply wasn't true. The 30mm cannon was far superior for taking out infantry and other vehicles than the 20mm cannon was. And by buffing the 30mm cannon even further, what you're going to find is that the mobile AA is now one of the most effective vehicles at taking out infantry. A more effective balance, I think, would have been making the 30mm cannons overheat much less than the 20mm cannons. And that would have increased the damage over time because you would be able to fire for longer. Next, we have tweaks to the gunship, the most loathed vehicle in the game, I think. And with changes to missiles and the AA, it's now an incredibly hard thing to take out without a jet going after it. So, what have they done to the gunship? They've increased its damage on every gun. So the splash damage and the range at which the JDAMs do their max splash damage is now increased. I'll admit the JDAM isn't the easiest weapon to use because there's a lot of predicting where vehicles are going to be when it hits, but stationary or slow moving infantry are now doomed. They've also increased the accuracy and direct hit damage of the 40mm cannons. And if you fire that in a burst, that thing is going to be like a laser beam. Now, the 40mm cannon wasn't that hard to use, and this is going to make it pretty deadly. they've increased the splash damage and the range of the 25mm cannons. That's now going to do 50% more damage, have more impact and more suppression. Now, who really thought that the AC-130 needed a buff? It's an unbalanced vehicle as it is, because the side that's winning in a round usually holds the control point, and you get the AC-130 from a control point. It's also unbalanced because if your side doesn't have a commander, it doesn't matter what you hold, you're not getting the AC-130. They've made it harder to shoot down because of the damage nerfs to Stingers and Igglers and the mobile AA, and the only really effective way of taking this thing down is with a jet. So I think this is a buff that's going to end up being rolled back. So again, we have a mixture of good tweaks and tweaks where you think, what the hell were you thinking? I think DICE might be looking too much at stats and not enough at gameplay. So that's all the fixes, tweaks and balances that have come to the consoles and should hopefully be arriving on PC soon. And that's it for this episode of Battlefield 4 News. Hopefully we'll soon get an update on Naval Strike and when the patch for PC is coming out. But until then, thanks for watching.